Ahoy, this is Zdenka. Let's take a break from all those tutorials and tech reviews and let's have some fun. 4 months ago, I published a video, the biggest mistakes I would never ever make again in photography in 2022. And you seem to really like it from what I was reading in the comments. So let's keep that series going. I got a lot more stories to tell, from twisted foot to broken cameras and more. This video is sponsored by Zyro. Let me start with the rookie beginner mistake. So when I started working as a photographer, all I was about is just to take photos. Reading a manual about the camera and the hardware on that was just a waste of time. I knew my settings. That's all I needed, wanted to know. And I wanted to shoot. One of my clients, Barry from Poolscape, incredible company, which builds this very luxury over-the-top pools in Ontario, Canada, asked me to shoot one of his pools. Back then I was using Canon 5D Mark II, I believe, and I was using lens 25 to 70 millimeters, I think, Canon. And he wanted some shots from above to take the photos of the whole pool. So he brought this very tall stepladder. The problem was that back then, at that time, I was pregnant and I was very close to due date. So he didn't want me to go up there. He didn't want to risk it. And we thought, okay, well, if I'm going to set up the camera, all he has to do to take it up there and just really press the shutter. So I set up the whole camera, gave him the camera. He climbed up and he was trying to take the photo from above. And suddenly he's like, well, it's not doing anything. I'm pressing the shutter, but it's not doing anything. So he came down and he gave me the camera and I was like, yeah, that's weird. How come it's not taking photos? And I'm holding the camera like this. I'm looking at the display. It was going all crazy. It was not reacting. So I let go because I wanted to fix the menu. As soon as I let go, the lens detached, boom, it went right to the pool. I think I paid about $1,500 for that lens at that time. So I lasted within a few seconds. What happened really, when he got the camera, he accidentally pressed the release button, the lens release button right next to it. I didn't realize it, he didn't realize it. And that's how the lens got detached. I took the lens to the store. They told me that it's beyond reasonable repair. So the lens was done. Barry obviously asked me if I have insurance. I didn't want him to pay for it. So I said, yeah, I do have insurance. I didn't have any, but yeah. Lesson learned, very careful around the pools. Don't go too close to the pool. Make sure you don't accidentally press the release button. One of the best jobs as a beginner photographer is to work for real estate, to take virtual tours of the houses for sale. And that's what I was doing the first, I believe, 2 years. I say it is the best job because I had to work with the flash, I had to shoot manually, and you have to work with different lighting conditions. Sometimes you shoot basement, then the bathrooms, main floor, outside. So the ISO is changing nonstop. You have to be able to work with different white balances and shutter speed. You get to know how to shoot in manual mode within 2 months. This is the best hands-on experience to have. Well, what happened there? It was winter. And snow was everywhere and ice, and they sent me to take the photos of the backyard. The real estate agent, she was inside with me, and she did give me a warning that there is a German Shepherd in the backyard, but it's very harmless, it's very friendly, it's not gonna do anything. So unlucky me, I did trust her, and I went to the backyard. I was standing on top this kind of small patio with this very deep staircase, and I started taking photos. As soon as the dog saw me, he started running towards me and he wanted to jump on me. I made a little move to the right just so he can pass me because she was calling him inside. I was holding my camera like this in the air and I made another step. I hit the edge of the stairs, and because there was an ice and everything, I literally crashed. I was falling down the stairs holding the camera in the air and wanted to make sure I don't break the camera. Well, I landed kind of weird on my foot. The camera was good, nothing happened to it. That was my main concern. I got to the car, I felt a little bit of pain, nothing major. The next day I woke up, my foot was twice a size big. So yeah, I was out of work for a good 2 weeks. Lesson learned, if you are working for real estate, doing virtual tours, make sure make it a rule that the pets need to be out of the way, or they have to be close somewhere, or somebody has to hold them. You can't be around just big dogs like this, because you never know what can happen. This is not the only time I fell during taking photos or videos. I fell a few more times. The last one was last year or 2 years ago, when I was reviewing one of the big gimbals and I had Sony A7S3 on it, so very expensive load. And I had tripod behind me with other camera. I was making sure that I'm in the frame so I can show how to work with the gimbal. And I forgot that I have camera back nearby. I left it there. It should have been under the tripod. I totally forgot about it. As I was backing up, I tripped over the camera back and I was flying backwards. Again, I was making sure the gimbal with the camera doesn't break, and I wanted to make sure. I hit my elbow on the rocks. Luckily, elbow was fine, just a few bruises. I have a lot harder falls when I'm figure skating. Trust me, there were a few times when I couldn't walk for a few days. But what was the main concern? That if I hit my head on the rocks, I was kind of filming in the middle of nowhere. There was nobody around, so nobody could really help me, find me. That way, I always say, be very careful when you're placing objects around you, when you're filming, make sure you put everything underneath the tripod, make sure everything is in one spot, so you simply don't forget those items are there and you don't trip, you break yourself or your equipment. I've got one more when it comes to dogs. Whenever you're watching my videos, which are filmed somewhere in the nature, I purposely choose areas where either no dogs are allowed or all pets must be on the leash, or dogs must be on the leash. Not that I'm afraid that I would get bit, but because of the equipment, something gets knocked over and there's a trouble right there. Obviously, once in a while, somebody breaks the rules and have their dog free. And it sucks, because sometimes they come and they jump on me, and if I'm on the camera, I try to stay clean and then all my clothes get dirty. Or sometimes the dogs are running and I just grab the tripod and I grab the camera and I'm waiting until the owner gets the dog and then I can work. They don't realize that those cameras, the tripod, can get knocked over, and I don't think they would be willing to cover the cost. Well, one time there's this man coming towards me with medium-sized dog, and so the obvious, I grabbed the tripod and the camera and I'm waiting for him and I'm waiting what he's gonna do. The worst happened. I had camera back on the ground. The dog came, lift his leg, and peed all over my camera back. Luckily, I had it zipped, so the rest of the equipment was well protected. I always zip it up. That's something I'm used to doing. You can imagine that I was not very happy. I said a few things to the owner. He just kind of walked by me and said, "Oh, it's okay, it's okay." And I lasted it. I said, "It's not okay, it's not okay." So eventually, 2 minutes later, he returned and he gave me his bottle with water so I can at least wash it off. So lesson learned. Now, when I'm filming, the first thing I'm doing, putting the camera backpack on my back, then grabbing the camera, and then holding the tripod, waiting until the situation with dogs is resolved. All right, before I tell you why Peter McKinnon owes me a coffee, let's talk about Zyro and thank them for making this video possible. I moved my website to this hosting company about half a year ago for many reasons. First of all, they are the most affordable option on the market right now, and they will let you sell from your website and also social media such as Facebook and Instagram and even Amazon. No coding, just drag and drop style. There are hundreds of pre-designed templates to choose from. You can create your own if you prefer. If you need help with anything, yes, they have 24/7 customer service and you are actually going to be talking to a person. What is important for me, for example, is the fact that the website is loading fast. You can create a blog and customize SEO, which makes you being found in search engines. All Zyro website plans have a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you change your mind, you cancel the subscription, you will get your money back. Click the link below or use my code Zdenka or to get a Zyro's limited time deal. Get an exclusive discount plus a custom domain and 3 months free with any yearly plan. When I was brand new on YouTube, a rookie, a shot knowing it all, even though you know absolutely nothing. And that was me in June 2018. I had a terrible accent, way worse than now. I had terrible echo in a studio and just very bad lighting and all this. Peter Mäkinen had this gear speed challenge going on. And I thought it would be fun to participate, why not? And back then, because I was beginner, I had just a very basic equipment. I was using this lavalier microphone with a very long wire under the table, which was leading to the camera. It was wired, it was not wireless. When you are new on YouTube, you are thinking about way too many things. You are just happy to actually record a video because everything is so still complicated for you. You also go on your smartphone all the time and you refresh your YouTube studio like a slot machine. Did anybody subscribe? Because the microphone was clipped on me, of course I forgot that I'm attached to the camera. And as I turned, I tried to reach for some gear for the gear speed challenge. I pulled it, I pulled the camera down, and it just was flying to the ground. Luckily, the camera didn't break, only the battery. I had to order and buy a new one. Back then, it was not very cheap for me, so that's why I'm saying kind of like, even though I know I will never ever meet up with Peter Mäkinen in person, but I'm gonna say that if that ever happens, I think that double espresso would be a thing. Lesson learned from this one, I immediately got rid of that wired microphone. From now on, only wireless microphone. I'm telling you, please invest in wireless microphones because there is kind of guaranteed for sure you're gonna pull the camera down or you're gonna break some sort of an equipment. Perhaps the most embarrassing video ever was the video titled Get Focus Sharp with Canon M50 Every Single Time. As you know, English is my second language. I was born in Czech Republic and I came to Canada when I was 19. Now, back then when I was starting as a rookie, as a beginner on YouTube, my accent was way stronger and my pronunciation was way worse. But as I was listening to myself while I was editing my videos, I realized those mistakes and I was trying to correct them the next time I was recording. So that's why some of the things are already better. Well, the region I'm from Hana. Basically, it's in Moravia. It's north of Moravia. We speak a little bit differently than people from Prague. For example, people from Prague would say the name of my hometown, Olomouc. They would say Olomouc, and I would say Olomouc, because we are from that region. So we add that "ots," Olomouc. So when I saw the word focus, I automatically assumed that you say focus. So the whole video I was saying that word and yeah. Here are hands-on focus techniques explained to the greatest detail and my bonus tips. From reading the comments, some people thought I said something different, which I didn't. They had a good kick out of it. It was quite embarrassing. I fixed that word right away. I have English police in the house. He's 12 and he's actually helping me quite a bit. When he's at home and I'm recording, he listens to me and sometimes he's like, stop. No, you're gonna make pause in the sentence right here, or stop. You gotta put stress in the word right here. Say it again. So he's helping quite a bit. Last week he was complaining that when I'm recording, I apparently sound different than when I'm talking to them in real life. And I know that because when I'm recording, I try to pronounce more and I'm trying to think about how I sound on the camera when I talk to them. I'm lazy, I'm just talking like this. And sometimes I even pretend, you know, to be the character, the Edna from Incredibles, and just say, you're beautiful. And they laugh because I guess it's funny. If you have an accent and you're just starting on YouTube or you're not confident with English yet, Don't be stressed. Don't worry about it. You will realize that there are so many wonderful people out there which will only say kind words and they will leave nice comments. I've had many of those. Some people were begging me not to ever lose the accent. Of course, there are a few which will leave very nasty comments too, but it is quite rare. The language gets only better over the time. The more you record, the more you listen to yourself while you are editing your videos. Give it a thumbs up if you had a little laugh or found some encouragement in today's video. And subscribe for more. Don't be shy to leave a comment, say hello, you know I read it all and I always respond. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.